You have this private gated entrance and this beautiful long flowing driveway, which then leads you directly to this beautiful regal motor court where you have the house front and center. 7 acres of land. Heading up these stairs, we have an extension of your great room with this nice seating area out here. Then you have these 3 French doors which open up, essentially making this outdoor seating area one with the indoor seating area. We're gonna head back inside now and check out this great room. Now check this out. On the ceilings, you have again that coffered white oak all exposed. Here is your wood-burning fireplace with limestone on the chimney. Nice white oak sturdy mantle. I love these tables in the front and center. These coffee tables are made out of travertine. I love the use of all the blends of different materials in here. It all just works really well. Above us, you have a modern chandelier. Off of your great room, totally separate, this is now the owner's wing of this mega mansion. And before you even get to the owner's bedroom, here's just another sitting area. On the walls, we have this rough exposed Texas limestone. Again, another wood-burning fireplace with a mini bar off into the corner there and a TV overhead. Also, you can't help but note this huge window throughout the whole house. I mentioned the cast iron rod windows, they are everywhere. So off of the sitting room, through this arch door, now we are into the owner's bathroom. So right off to my right, check this out. I mean, this had to have get craned into the space. This is one solid piece of marble for your freestanding soaking tub. You have the his and hers vanity, all the mirrors, have built-in touch beauty lighting. So with the push of a button, you have your beauty lighting. You also have your anti-steam, so your mirror will never fog up, and that's built in right there. Follow me over here. So behind your tub, this is your walk-in steam shower with the laser cut drain. You have the cast iron rod window here, all the marble up and down the walls. I love this bathroom. It's one of the most beautiful ones I've ever seen. But I want to show you this. So back out into the main space in the owner's bathroom, you have your water closets off to the side, and here is the hers closet. All the lighting is automated. It's all sensory, so when you walk in here, all the lights turn on. Beautiful jewelry display case front and center, modern chandeliers overhead. It looks more like a showroom than a closet with all the LED inlaid lights. It's just beautiful. And if we keep going ahead of us, this is mirrored on the other side. This would be the his closet. It's a very large bathroom. And again, all the lights turn on as you enter. Floor to ceiling storage. And I want to point this out. There's actually a secret passage door from his closet, which leads back into the home office. Pretty cool. In front of us, this is your owner's bedroom here in your Atlanta mega mansion with 25-foot high ceilings, all the exposed beams. I love how the wood has actually been sanded down to give it that rustic feeling. I love this space. I love the vaulted ceilings. It's very regal. It has a feeling of just kind of grandeur in the space. And you know, a lot of times in these home tours, we talk about the materials, but I think a home more than anything is about the feeling. And when you walk into this owner's bedroom, you just feel like you're king of the castle. From the owner's bedroom, through the owner's sitting room, through the great room, we are now back to that main entry, and I want to point this out. So you have your stairwell behind me, and then you also have your elevator access to all levels of the house. And if you look up, you actually have this red brick in the elevator vestibule with this vaulted ceiling, just giving another nice use of those natural materials in the space. We're not going to take the elevator, we're going to go up the stairs, but I want to point out you have this double height window allowing light into all 3 floors of this mansion. I think that's just such a nice use of design, and it really helps with the lighting in the space. At the top of your staircase, you have this nice landing with 2 bedrooms off to either side. We're gonna head into this first one. And just to show you the perspective, they're all really decent sized bedrooms, and they all have ensuite bathrooms and huge closets. But because it's a bit repetitive, we're just gonna show you this one. The one across the hall is essentially a mirror image of that. But heading on forward, this is your family room on the second level of the house. You have this beautiful wooden ping pong table. I like the nice royal blue here, American flag on the wall, another wood-burning fireplace with a TV overhead. And there's a whole other wing on the opposite side of the house. Off to the left, how cool is this? This is your secondary laundry room with all this antique tiling on the walls. And check this out, this is a dog washing station because I mentioned the owners have 2 huge Great Danes. So here you have the doggy shower. I like also how you have this antique faucet, deep set sink. Right across, you have this nice little day bed moment here to overlook your property, have a little cat nap. But if we keep on going, up here, this is essentially a whole nother apartment in the house. You have your media room, which opens up into your bedroom, which leads into your walk-in closet. And I love this bathroom. It's very moody. It's all matte black tiling. But now we're gonna cut back to the main entryway and we're gonna take the elevator down to the entertainment floor. So we are now on the lower floor entertainment wing, right off of the elevator. If you see behind me, this is a look at the bottom of that staircase, and you can see even from that window, it is so bright down here. It doesn't feel like we're on a lower level because that window utilizes the light so well. This is your wine cellar with the matte black paint, and I love how you have all the LED lights inlaid into this custom millwork, just giving it a very cool design and feeling. Leaving the wine cellar, I also want to point out that even on this lower level here, we have 12-foot high ceilings, so it doesn't give you that feeling of a lower level. Off my right, here we have an additional powder room. You have the quartzite here on the vanity countertop, this beautiful tile backsplash, and again, the smart mirror technology push to touch, illuminating that beauty lighting. It's awesome. Water closet here, but now the true selling point of this house is right in front of me. Check this out. Right off of your elevator, welcome to your entertainment floor, where we've got a lot going on, so let's break everything down. Off into the corner here, we have your blackjack table. You can play all your poker matches here, whatnot. Off to my left, here is your entertainment floor kitchen with a full built-in bar, refrigerator, dishwasher, the works. This is your in-house bowling alley with this custom mural here on the back wall by Matt Letters. And the mural gives a very street art urban feeling. You have your white oak pool table off to the left. And if we pull back here, this is where it gets interesting. So here is your fitness wing in this mega mansion. And off to my right, this right here, if you check this out, a current starts and you swim against the current, increasing how fast you want to go with how fast the current is pushing you. These are a lot of fun if you've ever been in one. I think it's pretty cool they have it in this house because they're pretty pricey. Off of your endless pool, here is your home, essentially wellness center. You have your mini sauna. I'm actually going to head in here because, wow, this is super cozy. I kind of like how the door is a bit smaller, but cedar sauna right off of your steam shower. Heading out of here, I want you to look at this. This is your home gym, and this is a proper home gym with all the equipment you could ever want. You have all the machines here. You have free weights galore, a bench, a leg sled. I love how you even have the rubber on the floor, so you could actually get a proper workout in here while viewing your endless pool. I love how they use those iron windows throughout the whole space. From your home fitness center, a few more pieces of equipment here, spin cycle, elliptical, making our way back past that bowling alley. You've got your pool table here, your life-size Jenga that you just came an inch away from hitting with the camera. Could you imagine if that actually knocked it over? But how cool is that? Which leads in to your family room, where you have the exposed brick wood-burning fireplace, tons of seating. Behind me here, welcome to your home theater in your Atlanta mansion. And it's so cool to see how far the dollar stretches in Atlanta compared to some of these other markets like Los Angeles or New York. Here, you have a legitimate movie theater in your house directly across from your home basketball court. Let's actually head down there now and check this out. Now, this is a true flex of one's wealth to have a regulation height basketball court here in your house. On the wall here, let's just take a moment. This awesome custom mural here of Kobe in the background. This is, this is a house for an athlete, I would say. This is a house for an entertainer. You even have your own scoreboard over top. What more could you ask for? We're gonna stick around here and show you what this place looks like in the evening hours, and then sit down with Deborah and hear a bit more about the Atlanta marketplace. Deborah, thank you for letting us tour your incredible listing. So for everyone out there watching, you might remember Deborah from a tour about what, 3 months ago?
3 months ago.
We toured the West Garland House?
Yes.
And you said that it's under contract, is that right?
Under contract.
There we go, that's what we like to hear. But now let's bring it back to this house, this specific build. It feels like someplace where you kick off your shoes, light the fire, watch a TV, you know, it just...
Turn on the music.
Yeah, a lot of homes in this price point don't really have that, especially ones that we've toured on the channel, but this one definitely has that feeling. Now let's talk about the entertainment floor.
Oh.
How crazy is that?
I love the indoor sports court. And then of course you have a bowling alley. And then a beautiful gym with a glass wall that opens to an indoor lap pool. So it's like you have everything down there and then it walks out to the property.
I mean, this is the perfect home for a pro athlete.
Yes.
So if you're out there and you live in Atlanta and you're watching this, contact Deborah. This is like the perfect entertaining house. In between seasons, you just want to come here and like, I mean, you could do everything here.
You could, and it's 6.5 acres, which is incredibly rare for this area.
Yeah.
To have all this privacy and the lake.
So as far as those buyers, are you seeing, what is the breakdown of your buyers? Is it more people in entertainment, in pro sports, or more business oriented, like people who are starting their own companies and that kind of nature?
You know, it's funny because I think this year, it's like a third, a third, and a third. I'm seeing everybody. And I think people are looking for luxury real estate with privacy, but yet, you know, in Buckhead or very close to Buckhead. I have clients in the music industry. Well, the film industry is always looking for luxury locations for filming. And then you've got, you know, business owners and entrepreneurs that are here or they're moving here.
That's a very cool mix of all of your clients. You know, you have the music, the athletes, the business people.
Oh yeah, the athletes too.
And then you're just right in the middle of all of it.
Yes.
It's exciting. So if you are looking for like a fun career, would you recommend real estate? You know?
Oh, I absolutely. It's like, you know, it's 7 days a week, but I love it. I love seeing and listing these homes and marketing them. The architecture is incredible. I mean, I love the business.
But also it's not by accident. Like, so I wake up pretty early and Deborah is there texting me at 5 a.m. to like confirm these shoots. So you're on it, you know, it's.
And you're answering, so it's
great. Yeah, try to get up early.
Yeah, I get up early just so I can start my day, exercise, and then just get prepared.
And that's a big part of, especially working for yourself and a career like being a real estate agent, is really structuring your day like that.
Absolutely, yes.
Wow, should Deborah start a YouTube channel? Comment down below.
No, wait a minute. I have a YouTube channel.
No, like you, I think vlogs, I mean, here, comment down below if you would want to see, you know, what goes into your brand. I mean, I think it's really intriguing.
Yes. Yeah. I really love it.
I put you on the spot right there.
You did.
I'm so sorry for that. I'm so sorry for that. Anyway, though, if you like this property and you're out there and you're looking to potentially purchase it, all the information is down below in the description of this video. Deborah, thank you again for letting us tour your incredible property.
Absolutely.
And with that, we will see you in the next episode.